In this video, I will talk about a little convenience on keyframes. Normally, when we create keyframes to animate, we use EZs to make these movements look smoother. And if necessary, we try to reach the movement we want by opening the graph editor and playing on the dots. Let's just give a keyframe. I take the car to the left and here I give a position keyframe. At the end of the timeline, I also give a keyframe. And while the timeline is in the middle, I move the object like this. Normally, when we play it this way, it will be a static animation. And we can make all of them smoother with F9 or right-clicking here and selecting EaseEase with the keyframe assistant here. But in some cases, we may need to check the lines here as well. For example, we can get different images by swiping to the left. We can achieve different animations, different animation speeds. These processes can be a little boring. And when there are several layers, it can get complicated. Now, I will show you a way to make these operations easier. We will use a plugin for this. The plugin is called Animation Composer. By downloading and installing this application, you also get these options installed. Keyframe Wingman is the plugin we will be using in this video. It has a window like this. I open the graph editor again and let's see the edits we will make with this Keyframe Wingman panel. First, we need to select the keyframes and then we can do the tricks here. We can quickly perform smoothing and editing operations on keyframes using only the sliders here. At the moment, both are acting at the same time. When we remove the middle chain, we can only edit the left side or we can only edit the right side. As you can see, it's a much easier method than holding the arrows over there. Rather than trying to keep the points here, as I said, when there are several layers, these will be much more complex. You may have confusion about which point belongs to which layer. But even keeping the dots here, at least can be a hassle sometimes. Therefore, we can use the points here to avoid these difficulties. By editing the selected ones, we can quickly add smooth movements to these keyframes. Of course, as you do this, you should see what looks better for yourself to get used to the keyframes here. By using this feature, you can dominate keyframes and make your animations look much smoother and more realistic. Yes, in this video, I showed you how to use the Keyframe Wingman plugin, which is one of the useful plugins. By directly downloading the Animation Composer plugin, you can have these plugins installed automatically. That's it for this video. If this video helped you out, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.